The book Foundation and Earth details the quest of Golan Treviz and Janov Pelaret to locate the long-forgotten birth planet of humanity, Earth. Eventually, they make their way to the binary star system Alpha Centauri, where they find a planet mostly water. Its inhabitants call it New Earth. From there, they surmise that the original Earth must be close. Earth turns out to be an irradiated world, incapable of sustaining life due to war. But on the moon lived one sentient life form, R. Daniil Alova. Daniil was a robot that had been created almost 20,000 years prior. His first appearance in Asimov's work was in the 1954 novel Caves of Steel, a detective story in which Daniil, the first humaniform robot ever created, helps to solve crime. Daniil was created by roboticists from the planet Aurora named Roj Naminasartan and Han Fastolf, and was designed in the image of Roj. He was indistinguishable from a human. In Foundation and Earth, Golan and Janov learned that Daniil had been the hidden manipulator of human destiny. Long before Harry Seldon and even the Galactic Empire, Daniil had ruled the galaxy in secret with the help of his many robot allies. Daniil is responsible for the creation of the Galactic Empire itself, and created the laws of humanics known as psychohistory, which he later manipulated Harry Seldon into bringing into a practical form. Daniil also created Gaia, a planet in which all human beings evolved into a group consciousness that also maintained individuality. Eventually, this consciousness would spread to all humanity, creating Galaxia, a living organism which contained all life forms and non-living material in the galaxy. Daniil wanted to alter humankind for the better. Daniil's actions are based upon Asimov's laws, also referred to as the three laws of robotics. 1. A robot may not injure a human being or through inaction allow a human being to come to harm. 2. A robot must obey the orders given by human beings except where such orders would conflict with the first law. 3. A robot must protect its own existence as long as such protection does not conflict with the first or second laws. There is actually a fourth law, known as the Zeroth Law. This law is crucial in understanding Daniil's actions. The Zeroth Law was created after the other three, but supersedes them. It states that a robot may not harm humanity or by inaction allow humanity to come to harm. The Zeroth Law allows a robot to harm an individual human if it is done in service to all humanity. Since the concept of humanity is abstract and the subtleties of harm versus well-being can be vague, it took Daniil thousands of years to adapt himself to be able to obey the Zeroth Law fully. Treviz frowned. How do you decide what is injurious or not injurious to humanity as a whole?
Precisely, sir, said Daniil. In theory, the Zeroth Law was the answer to our problems. In practice, we could never decide. A human being is a concrete object. Injury to a person can be estimated and judged. Humanity is an abstraction.
Foundation and Earth. Harry Seldon's plan turned out to essentially only be a backup plan to Daniil's vision of the Galaxia's superconsciousness. Daniil could not tell whether the creation of Galaxia would ultimately hurt humankind due to its inherent unpredictable nature. Therefore, he could not definitively say whether or not the Zeroth Law actually permitted it. Harry Seldon's psychohistory was there in case the situation arises where Galaxia was determined not to be the best course of action. The likelihood of advanced life forms somewhere out there in the cosmos eventually attacking humanity was great. Extraterrestrials would give mankind no hope of expansion, and humankind would eventually become extinct. Daniil's work could prevent such a thing happening. At the end of Foundation and Earth, it turns out that Daniil's positronic brain is failing. His original brain had lasted 10,000 years and had since been upgraded many times, becoming more complex and more fragile.
Though Daniil's final brain is several orders of magnitude more complex than his initial brain, it showed signs of deterioration after only 6 centuries. He intends to merge his brain with the child Phalum, who was taken from the planet Soloria, which was inhabited by a race of humans who had engineered themselves to become hermaphrodites capable of self-reproduction. Daniil is the oldest conscious being in Asimov's body of work. No book was ever written on the creation of the Galaxia superconsciousness, but it is assumed that Daniil lived to see it come into existence. A planet might deteriorate, even if human beings existed upon it, if the society were itself abnormal and did not understand the importance of preserving the environment. Surely, said Pelorit, such a society would quickly be destroyed. I don't think it would be possible for human beings to fail to understand the importance of retaining the very factors that are keeping them alive. Bliss said, I don't have your pleasant faith in human reason, Pell. It seems to me quite conceivable that when a planetary society consists of isolates, local and even individual concerns might easily be allowed to overcome planetary concerns. Isaac Asimov, Foundation and Earth. How's it going, guys? I want to take this time to thank my top 3 patrons, Trini Girl, Cher Valentine, and John Stanton. Thanks for being so generous, and thanks to everyone that supports this channel. If you would like to support this channel on Patreon, click the link in the description. Check out the Asimov playlist on this channel for more videos exploring this complex universe.